Good morning.
Good morning.
And happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
Welcome to the First United Methodist Church of Del Mar. Whether you are here with us in person or joining us via live stream or watching the recording of the service later on, we are confident in the power and presence of God to connect us beyond time and space. And so we are grateful for that. We don't do business on Easter Sunday in particular. There are some announcements in your bulletin, so I want to make sure to direct your attention to those. But I trust that you will investigate that on your own as we are here to gather and celebrate the resurrection. So let us center our hearts and minds in worship.
Thank you.
strike all commercial.
We gather, a community of faith in God's subversive world. We gather to celebrate that no darkness can extinguish light. To remember that love will always be more powerful than death. And to trust that peace will always be stronger than violence.
We gather, people of faith, in the light of God's word.
Let us join in singing the hymn of 320, Lord, Christ the Lord is today, verses 1-4.
Multicolored company, church, on earth and in heaven. We
We celebrate your creation, your life, your death and resurrection. And so we pray.
Lord, we bring you life where we are born and tired. New love where we have turned our hearts. Forgiveness where we have hurt and where we have wounded. And joy and freedom of your Holy Spirit, where we are prisoners of ourselves. Amen.
Now hear these words of grace. To all and to each, on his community and on his friends, Jesus pronounced pardon and grants us the right to be given him. Thanks be to God.
Amen.
And now, let us join in voicing the Lord's Prayer as we bow to the presence of the Lord.
And invite the children to come forward and join me for some time up front together.
Come, O children of the Lord, sons and daughters of God. Come, O children of the Lord, and hear the word of God. Anyone who lives in God is simply living in life. Anyone who lives in God, no longer walks in the dark. Come, O children of the Lord, sons and daughters of God. Come, O children of the Lord, and hear the word of God.
Good morning. How's everybody doing, children? Guys, up late last night? It's tough. I've been up since 5 o'clock this morning, so how you doing? You good? How about on this side? Are we a little live here? No? Well, that's already live here. I think you are. Yeah. Good morning. Happy Easter. Thank you. Happy Easter. Happy Easter. You already have bunnies at your house. But did you have any other bunnies visit your house, too? Probably. Yeah. Does the Easter bunny come by and hang out with your bunnies? Maybe. A little bunny party. Middle of the night. Who knows? So this morning I have a book that is actually a poem by Amanda Gorman, who's a really wonderful young African-American woman poet. She actually wrote a poem for the last presidential inauguration. And this is called Change Sings. So I want to read this and I'm going to talk about why.
I can hear change humming in its loudest, proudest song. I don't fear change coming, so I sing along. I scream with the skies of red and blue streamers. I dream with the cries of tried and true dreamers. I'm a chant that rises and rings. There is hope where my change sings. Though some don't understand it, those windmills of mysteries, I sing with all the planets and its hills of histories. I hum with 100 hearts, each of us lifting a hand. I use my strengths and my smarts, take a knee to make a stand. I'm bright as the light each day brings. There is love where my change sings. I show others tolerance, though it might take some courage. I don't make a taller fence, but fight to build a better bridge. I talk not only of distances, from where and how we came. I also walk our differences to show we are the same. I'm a movement that roars and springs. There's a wave where my change sings. Change sings where? There, inside me. Because I'm the change I want to see. As I grow, it grows like seeds. I am just what the world needs. I'm the voice where freedom rings. You're the love your bright heart brings. We are the wave starting to spring. We are the change we sing. We're what the world is becoming. We know it won't be long. We all hear change strumming. Won't you sing along? So today, Easter is a day about change. Did you know that? It's all about change. It's a day when we remember and celebrate that God turned the world upside down. Change everybody's understanding of the way things work. Jesus was always talking about that, remember? He said things like, you know, blessed are the poor. Did you know, did you remember that he said that? Blessed are the poor. Now that does it seem like the poor would be blessed? No, but that's what he said. He said things like, the last will be first and the first will be last. The last will be first and the first will be last. So he was trying to let people know that we were talking about a very different kind of way of understanding the world. And on Easter, when everybody said, well, Jesus died and that's the end, Jesus said, not so fast. Right? And his disciples, some of them, and it was the women who went first. Did you know that? It was the women who went first. And they realized that something unbelievable had happened. And we're going to hear all kinds of stories over the next several weeks about all these experiences that people had of Jesus after he died and was resurrected. He all of a sudden wasn't dead, he was actually alive with them. So, and there's all kinds of stories because it was something so amazing and incredible and unbelievable that they didn't really even know how to describe it. Can you imagine, have you ever had something happen that's so incredible that you don't even have the words to really describe what it was like? That's what it was like for them. Can you imagine that? And so it was all about change. All of a sudden, everything was different. All of their expectations were turned upside down. And all of a sudden, they realized that God was so much bigger than all of their fears and all of their doubts and all of the problems of the world, that there was hope. And that's what Easter is all about. It's about hope. But it also, because Jesus came back and appeared to all of his friends to let them know that it was now not just on him, then it was their turn to make some change. It was their turn to make a difference in the world. So that's what this day is a reminder of. It's a reminder that it's now our turn to make a big difference in the world, to make the world a better place. All right? So as we celebrate today, one of the things we're going to be thinking about is all the ways in which we can make the world a better place. And I'm confident that all of you can play a big part in that. All right? Let's pray before you go back to your seats. We're going to stay in worship today. Let's pray. Wonderful God, we thank you for this day of Easter, this day of celebration, this day of new beginnings. We thank you for reminding us that we are the change that we hope for. Help us as we work with you to make the world a better place, to be the change that you are leading us to be. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thanks so much for coming up. In this season of resurrection, this season of hope, this season of new beginnings, this season of rebirth, we are reminded of the incredible opportunities that we have before us to be change in the world, to bring hope into people's lives, to offer people new beginnings. This congregation is one that reaches out into all kinds of different places, both near and far, to bring light into dark corners, to bring change into people's lives, to let them know that God loves them no matter what. As I had the opportunity to remind a friend and colleague just recently, God loves you and there's nothing you can do about it. I learned that from my wife. God loves you and there's nothing you can do about it. And that is the message that we take into the world through all of the ministries and missions that we provide. Thank you for all of the ways in which you support those and make those happen. The ushers will assist us as we gather tithes and offerings. Thank you.
Praise God, O gracious Emmanuel. Alleluia, alleluia. Praise God, the source of all our gifts. Praise Jesus Christ, whose power uplifts. Praise the Spirit, Holy Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia. Hallelujah.
Please join with me in the prayer of dedication found in your bulletin. Let us laugh so much, O God, that we become laughter. Let us sing so much that we become song. Let us give so much that we become gift. Amen. And let us remain standing as we're able as we sing together hymn number 303, the Day of Resurrection. In your resurrecting power, lift them up and give them renewed strength and hope. And give to us all new faith by which to live our days with you. And will our lives be living witness to your resurrection, made whole by your love and care. In Christ's spirit we pray.
Amen.
Our gospel reading this morning comes to us from the 28th chapter of Matthew's gospel, beginning with the first verse. Will you rise as you are able to hear the gospel?
After the Sabbath, at dawn on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to look at the tomb. Look, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven. Coming to the stone, he rolled it away and sat on it. Now his face was like lightning, and his clothes as white as snow. The guards were so terrified of him that they shook with fear and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Don't be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He isn't here because he's been raised from the dead, just as he said. Come, see the place where they laid him. Now hurry, go and tell his disciples he's been raised from the dead. He's going on ahead of you to Galilee. You will see him there. I've given the message to you." With great fear and excitement, they hurried away from the tomb and ran to tell his disciples. But Jesus met them and greeted them. They came and grabbed his feet and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Don't be afraid. Go and tell my brothers that I'm going into Galilee. They will see me there." This is God's word for God's people. Thanks be to God. Please be seated. It was in the spring of 1994. I had finally come to accept a call to ministry. And I had let everyone in my life know, the community of faith in my home church in Saranac Lake. I'd let people at my place of employment, I worked at a radio station there, know that I was going to be headed off to seminary, and so that I would not be working there anymore after the end of July. The owner of the station was wonderful about continuing to have me employed there, so I was able to let him know far in advance. I had applied and been accepted at Drew University School of Theology. Everything felt right and good. Yes, there was a bit of anxiety and trepidation, but I was confident that I was headed on the right path. And then the financial aid offer came. And there was this gap of about $5,000 that I was somehow supposed to make up between scholarships and loans and the amount that would be due. And suddenly my world came crashing down, because even if I had some employment during my time in seminary, I wasn't sure how I was going to make up this $5,000 gap. And I remember sitting on the edge of the bed one morning, just feeling like I had made a huge mistake, like somehow I'd gotten it wrong. I had sorted through all of this, thought I knew exactly where God was leading me. In the midst of all that, and in a sense of panic, just felt so dejected. And suddenly I felt a hand on my shoulder, and an incredible sense of peace. Because Jesus was there with me. Now, I didn't turn around and see him. I didn't even see a print where he would have been sitting on the bed next to me. But I clearly felt that hand on my shoulder. And instead of being frightened, had an incredible sense of calm assurance. I've never had that experience again. I've had profound experiences of the Holy Spirit working and moving around me. I've been with people in situations where they've been in the hospital in the midst of crisis and praying with them and felt a wind surround us that I couldn't explain. Felt an incredible warmth in my heart, maybe like John Wesley described, as his heart was strangely formed. I've had lots of other experiences like that, never before again. Felt that clear sense of the risen Christ with me. And a sense of calm assurance of his presence. Anytime I've told that story, I've had people come up to me quietly and say, "Me too." But everybody is afraid to tell those stories. Sometimes there are people that say, "I've never experienced anything like that." That's okay. It was what I needed in that moment. But it was that sense of not being afraid. And I resonate with Jesus' words to those who met him in the graveyard that day. Met him at the empty tomb. When he says, "Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid." We know from the stories of this past week how terribly frightening all these events were, right? Strange things were happening, stranger than they had encountered along their travels with Jesus up until then. And he had said some peculiar things like, "This is my body and this is my blood," and had washed their feet. And he had been betrayed, and he had been arrested, and he had been beaten and abused and executed by the state. And in the midst of all of that, in the midst of all of this terror and violence and death, Jesus suddenly breaks forth from the tomb and says, "Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid." We live in a world that is terrifying. We try to ignore it. We try to pretend it's not. But we live in a world that is terrifying, a world that is ripped with violence, a world that is in the grasp too often of evil and anger and hatred. We live too often in a place where it's easy to despair. We want to pull the covers up over our head, think somehow it's all just a huge mistake. And we seek assurance, we seek comfort in all kinds of things like money. If only I had just a little bit more. Or we lock ourselves behind doors and we put up security cameras and we think now we'll be safe. Or we arm ourselves and think now we'll be safe. We have more guns, and we have more tanks, and we have more planes, and we have more ships, and we have more bombs than anybody else. Now we'll be safe. Now we don't have to be afraid, and yet we're more afraid than ever. In the midst of the terror, in the midst of the violence, in the midst of the suffering, in the midst of our despair, Jesus wants to break in and say, "Don't be afraid." But it's hard for us to wrap our minds around that. It's hard for us to imagine a world where there is no fear. A world where there is no violence, a world where there is no anger, a world where there is no despair. A world like the one that Jesus describes. where the poor and the suffering and those who mourn are blessed, where the hungry are fed and the rich sent away empty, where the mighty are brought down and the lowly are lifted up. We remember that story in the days leading up to Christmas of Mary's hymn of praise, where she predicts that's what's going to happen. And we see glimpses of it through the life and ministry of Jesus, but this, on Easter Sunday, is the moment when it all comes into focus. And yet too often, we go from Hosanna to Hallelujah. We brush past the parts in the middle if we glimpse them at all. And then we step out into the world and act as if nothing happened. We forget that everything is different. Don't be afraid, Jesus said. And still, in the days following, we'll hear next Sunday that the disciples were locked in the upper room because they were afraid. And again, they want to fall back into that fear. But every time they overcome it, every time they step beyond it, every time they lean into it, embrace it, and then remember that experience of the resurrected Christ, they step into life with a new sense of boldness and courage. It was one day in the spring of 1994. When I felt the hand of Jesus on my shoulder, and an incredible sense of peace and calm. Life and ministry try to drive that out of me sometimes, try to pull me away from that. But every time I lean into it, God draws me back. Jesus said, don't be afraid. He knew we were going to be. But he also is letting us know that the risen Christ is in our midst, walking, waiting for us, there for us in those moments of terror and panic, of anxiety and grief, calling to us again and again, do not be afraid. Go and tell about the resurrection, and I will go and be there with you. Do not be afraid. Amen. Responses for our sacrament this morning are printed there in your bulletin and also found on at number 2257 in the Faith We Sing, as we will be singing together. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right to offer our thanks and praise as we recall the mystery of your eternal presence. Through the example of Jesus, your love was made more real to us. And through your Spirit, our lives are filled with grace. When we forget, when we doubt, when we turn away, you are there. Even in our imperfection, you call us to embody your presence as Jesus did, that others might know the infinite love that is grace. And so, as disciples of Jesus, we join our voices with those others throughout the world in a hymn of praise.
Holy, 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 Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest.
In this act of Holy Communion, we remember that on the last night Jesus gathered with his friends. He took bread, blessed it, broke it, and gave it to them, saying, "This is my body, broken for you." And afterward, he took the cup, blessed it, and gave it to them, saying, "This is my love poured out for you. When you do this, remember me." Now, as we share these gifts, the bread, which recalls the reality of Christ's presence, the cup, which recalls a life lived fully in God, we offer our own lives to the service of God and proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
May we know Christ's presence, God's love embodied, and these gifts of bread and cup. And may we be blessed and empowered by that Spirit which transcends all our understanding. For all the ways our lives are touched by Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer, we offer praise and thanks.
Amen, amen, amen. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest.
My servers will come forward. Lee, will you come help serve also? Thank you. Nancy. And Susan, if you would come up as well. Heather, would you come up and serve as well? is Christ's table. It's not yours or mine. It doesn't belong to the United Methodist Church. It is his, and he invites all to come and share who wish to experience him anew, who wish to know him in this profound way. As we share this act of remembering, of bringing Christ back together and experiencing him in community. There was no prerequisite. You didn't miss the 101 class. You don't have to have everything figured out and all of the answers. In fact, please don't tell me you do, because I'll feel very sad for me that I don't. You're invited to come and receive these gifts of grace.
Thank you.
there anyone else that needed to be served? Let us pray. Most unbelievable God, we give you thanks for the gift of your presence in these gifts of bread and cup and in this act of sharing together in community. And as we have received so freely of all that you offer us, we ask that you send us forth into the world to offer ourselves as freely for others. As in Christ's name we pray. Known to say, especially at times like Christmas Eve and Easter, we always want this to have this sense of awe and mystery and precision and elegance that in some ways belies the experience of the meal that Jesus shared. Because if you think about it, it was 13 guys around the table with wine. And so there's an honesty to the imprecision and the crumbs and all of the other pieces. It's a lot like that experience of the empty tomb. It's real. It's scary. It's beyond our imagination and understanding. And yet, it very much is God present here and now with us, and so we give thanks. We rise as you are able as we sing together our closing hymn number 2238, In the Faith We Sing, In the Midst of New Dimensions.
People pouring out of their despair.
Not to be afraid, but to live with boldness and courage and faithfulness, to see the world with hope. Go forth this day as witnesses to the resurrection. Even if you don't have the words, even if you don't quite understand it, even if it's beyond your imagination, go forth this day and proclaim the risen Christ. Go forth to invite others into a life without fear. Go forth this day and offer hope. And go forth this day in peace. Amen.
Hallelujah, amen, amen, hallelujah, amen.
Hallelujah, amen, amen, hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yeah.